All right, so we are going to Iceland.
We start here and we do a full circle of the island.
It's a big road trip. We're going to be staying in this van, sleeping, camping, cooking all our meals in there. We can pull over and sleep wherever we want. Our biggest concerns are one of the volcanoes there, Barbadunga, could potentially erupt.
European travelers, be warned. Seismic authorities in Iceland have said that its largest volcano could erupt at any time.
And luckily, there's no new updates to our flight. We're pretty much all packed.
Here's the itinerary.
Since we were planning this whole trip ourselves, and it was a loose plan of, you know, we got to get here, then tomorrow we got to get here, I put together this itinerary, which shows us doing a clockwise circle around the entire country. We just follow the Ring Road Highway, which is similar to PCH in LA, because it just runs right along the coast. What we didn't know was that because of the Barbadunga volcano and the risk of flooding in the north, we'd basically have to reverse this entire plan and circumnavigate the country counterclockwise.
We just got to Delta, and it is literally the longest line I've ever seen.
Why?
What happened?
The baggage thing broke.
We were flying through JFK to Reykjavik, Iceland. It was about a 6-hour flight to JFK.
We're going.
We are at JFK and we are going to Iceland.
And then another 6-hour flight to Reykjavik. Overall, it's a 7-hour time difference from LA. We arrived at 9:20 in the morning at Keflavik Airport. We were picked up by the Happy Camper Company, and then they took us to pick up our van. Mara and I had only had a few hours of stick shift driving lessons. Neither of us knew how to drive stick, so we stalled the car 3 times trying to get out of the parking lot, and it was just a nightmare getting out of the city.
Mara is the best driver in the world. Volcano potential has caused us to reverse our plan.
Eventually, we found our campsite, but it was only 3 in the afternoon, and we wanted to stay up until around 9 to adjust the time change. But if we sat still, we'd fall asleep, so we decided that we should just go for a hike.
We are at our first campsite, and we're an hour into our hike, and we're hiking up a hill.
I think our campsite is somewhere in those trees. We're on the south coast of Iceland.
Eventually, at around 6 o'clock, we decided it was time to make some dinner.
Whoa, that's the stove.
Whoa.
Mara, back up. It's not good.
Stop filming and do something.
Here's what happened.
Our stove caught on fire and it melted the dowel completely, so we couldn't use it anymore.
Connor and I spent a large portion of our life savings on this trip, which is off to a disastrous start. So far I've stalled the car 30 times. The stove caught on fire. We can't make a U-turn or go in reverse, so we really need this.
We landed here at Keflavik. We came all the way up here to Reykjavik, went southeast along the one, and then just before reaching Selfoss, we turned left, and then we made camp at the one right there.
It's pretty spacious in here. I'm a little bit too tall for the bed. It's 8 o'clock. The sun is still shining, and it'll still be shining until 10 o'clock. But we're trying to stay awake as long as we can.
And with no stove.
With no stove. We haven't decided what we're going to do about the stove. It's just the beginning.
Hey, who wants some hearty oats for breakfast? It's like granola, kind of.
On the road again. Today we woke up at our awesome camp. We
got 13 hours of sleep.
We got like
to bed at 8.
And then we drove north inland up to Geyser, and like the big geyser that goes off.
You see the bubble? That is so cool.
To a big waterfall with a rainbow called Gullfoss.
Tærnar grafnar í rauðum sandi. Sól og blíða út á landi.
Go Fox. And we're gonna try and find a town called Selfoss where we're gonna stock up on more groceries.
And a stove, hopefully.
And a stove, since our other one caught fire. We have to figure out what to do about that. This is our camp for the night. Here's our chairs. You're on camera. Just outside of Selfoss. We have to kind of hang around here until tomorrow so we can get a stove at the big outdoor store. Behind me, you can kind of see some clouds on the horizon. I'm a little bit nervous about them. It's more clouds than we've seen before. We've just mastered driving. Looks like our next challenge could be rain. Day two, we drove all the way up to check out Geyser and Gullfoss, then drove back down to Selfoss and camped just outside of Selfoss. All right, here we are, another day on the frontier. Boy. And Mara has a few words to share.
No.
Mara?
I haven't washed my face yet. No! Go away! No!
Some horses rode by our camp. I tried to film them. I thought I was filming them, and all I got was a piece of meat eating my breakfast. Heard of horses out there just passed through. I thought I was recording, but I wasn't. Went to the store, we were looking for a stove, but they said they were all sold out. They said they're all finished. But there was one in like the sports section that they had that was like a single gas burner, like water heater basically. So we got that.
It was really inexpensive.
It's like $200. And now we are on the open road going to check out two waterfalls today. We think that we've spotted the waterfall, Seljan de Foss, in the distance there on the left. There it is. We were young boys smoking in the woods. I showed you how. We were young boys smoking in the woods. I showed you how. We were young boys smoking in the woods. I showed you how. We were young boys smoking in the woods. I showed you how. All right, we're on the road again. So it pretty much just looks like we're driving through Ohio.
Oh God, why is there a bird in the road?
Okay, there's a bird in the road, just fine. You're fine. You're a sly dog.
Not a good place to stop.
So the volcano has erupted about 30 minutes ago and they've evacuated everywhere north of the glacier.
A small eruption, there might be another one.
And they moved the aviation code from orange to red. We're safe all along the south and east coast, but once we get to the east, we will ask there and make a decision. Very likely we have to basically turn back around. And then there's some mean rain clouds out there. Looks like they missed us, luckily. We're now going to check out Skaga Foss.
We were young boys smoking in the woods. I showed you how. We were young boys smoking in the woods. I showed you how. We were young boys smoking in the woods. I showed you how. We were young boys smoking in the woods. I showed you how.
So we're here at our camp for the night, right at the base of the volcano that erupted a few years ago. We got our new stove right here. Hopefully this is gonna cook us some mac and cheese.
This is take three. Take four, stove versus Connor. All right, looking good. Starting to boil. Maybe you wanna turn it down. Turn down, can you turn it down? That's perfect. Feast.
Having mac and cheese. What's over there in the background?
Connor's been saying there's gonna be rain for the past, like, I don't know, day and a half.
It's because there is. And today we drove east out along the one. We stopped here at Seljan de Foss, and then we kept going to Skaga Foss waterfall. And then we drove back to the number three to camp, and we're right below the volcano Ejafjallajökull.
Eyjafjallajökull.
We're on the road to Vik, into the eye of the storm.
We spent day 4 checking out this really cool town called Vik. It's a small town on the south coast of Iceland of about 400 people. In the school, they actually had black sand sandboxes, and they'd basically just taken this volcanic sand straight from the beach. We went for a walk along the beaches. We checked out some small caves. We checked out these huge coastal bluffs.
Connor's a mountain goat.
Then we put gas in the car and stocked up on water.
Connor is refilling our water.
We made some ramen for lunch.
Driving back and forth between...
I forgot my gloves!
Tamara forgot her gloves. And so we are driving back and forth between Vik and Dyrhólaey.
We spent the rest of the day hiking up and around Dyrhólaey, this huge rock peninsula with this big arch. We hiked out along it, and then we found an amazing spot for dinner, totally by ourselves, with an epic view.
We're just cooking up a little bit of hot water.
Here's Mara.
Hi!
Making sandwiches. Got our ramen there.
Then we hiked back down and walked along the beach for sunset. That night we headed east a little bit outside of Vik, just outside the town, because we wanted to go back the next day to use the swimming pools.
Here we are. Say hi, Mara.
No!
We're day 6. No, day... Here we are, day 5 on the frontier. You know, we're just parked here right off the freeway. Today we're gonna go back into Vik, and we're gonna get some gas and some coffee, and we're gonna swim, and then we're going to head east, northeast to the Skaftafell National Park.
Move.
She's closing herself in, she's got bugs.
Breakfast of champions.
We're driving to Skaftafell National Park.
Skaftafell National Park to do some hiking for a few days. And this is our longest drive yet, it's about 2 hours. Right now we're on Mars.
We've seen 3 very interesting spots that I wish we could have stopped, but if we have to come back this way because of the volcano, then we'll stop and check it out and do Mara's favorite thing.
What?
Photo shoots.
Photo shoots.
Photo shoots.
I thought you were going to say eating.
Mara's favorite thing is eating. Here's out my window to the sun. The sky's cleared up nicely, so the rain seems to be gone.
Seems to be some rain on the left rolling in.
Someone got busted.
Should I give him the thumbs up?
No.
Let's see if we can find some radio. Nothing.
Coming up on another waterfall. So wherever there's a bridge, it narrows into one lane.
Glaciers that are part of Skaftafell National Park.
All right, you're on video. Tell us where we are.
Nope. And then we stopped here at Skaftafell National Park, and there was this really cool waterfall, Svartafoss.
Just pulled over. We could see this glacier in the background. And we just hiked out to the lake and got all the way out here.
Leave me.
some Nutella and banana for dessert. It's delicious.
Day 6 off the grid. Just woke up and there is a full rainbow.
We are waiting for the defroster.
It takes a little defrost
while. The window.
We are going to go to the Iceberg Lagoon. With Hobson's Harper Lake, Fleetum Erlesteinum, Blauskelikri Leinum, Aldan Ber, Afrelsi Keim, Svalar Hjörtum Tveim, Færir Okkur Aftur.
To drive about an hour through Hoppen, and then we're gonna drive about an hour north to the East Fjords. We pulled off on the side of the freeway here.
Gotta stay warm.
We are heading to the east. Thought we found a spot, and then we decided to keep going because it wasn't that great. And so we went in and out of these fjords in the east. Mara drove for an extra hour, and we ended up finding this place. We backed our van up to the ocean front, so you can see tonight we're going to be dining cliffside in the fjords of eastern Iceland. That's dedication, folks. Mara doing her abs. We're going to a pretty town in a big fjord.
Called Sachigachibachna.
Called Sadis Fjorder.
Yes, Sadis Fjorder.
I don't know if you can see anything, but this tunnel is like a cave. It's 5,900 meters, so it's like 3 miles or 6 kilometers or something like that. And it's just going. We're hiking in the mountains above Sadis Fjorder, which you can see in the distance.
Thank you.
We are day 8. We are just outside of Seyðisfjörður, just down there is the fjord. And yesterday we did a hike that was just up there along the bluffs. Last night we camped here next to this waterfall. We're gonna go to the visitor center and see if we can get some information on the volcano, and then we're probably gonna head west to the lake area to drive past it, stay west of it, and then spend tomorrow driving back to check it out for the day.
Here we are crossing the river system that leads to Dettifoss, that if the volcano erupted and a glacier melted, this whole thing would flood. This is the area where all the roads are closed. So north of us, which is tomorrow's left, way, way, way back there is where the volcano is under the glacier, if a flood were to come and move down that whole river system.
Safety.
Safety first. Mara has decided that we're going into the eye of the storm. We're going to Dettifoss.
We're gonna give it a try.
The road will probably be closed, but we're gonna see.
A little nervous.
We're going 10 kilometers an hour.
12.
Every other car seems to just be flying down this road.
Maybe they just don't care that it's bumpy.
Should we just floor it? Bad idea. The road is a little too bumpy for Harry. We're turning around. We're in the process of making our 10-point turn. We figured, you know, the last thing we want is a flat tire in the floodplain of the volcano. But it's very hard to turn around.
Both physically and mentally.
Physically and mentally tough.
It's hard to turn around. Well, folks, we've seen it all.
We are driving into Húsavík.
Húsavík is this small town of about 2,000 people in the north that's known for its whale watching.
Update! We just had a delicious lobster dinner and Mara had 2 vegetable skewers. And now we're driving north to Tungulendin or Hallabjarnarstoir. We're hoping to find some fossils. This whole peninsula is supposed to be fossil-ridden. We're gonna make Mara some dinner, and then we're gonna go on a sunset fossil walk. And maybe a morning fossil walk, too.
What? Double fossil walk?
Double fossil walk.
That's news to me.
News to Mara.
Day 9 on the frontier. Yeah. We are just outside of Húsavík. Today we're going to have some breakfast, and then we're going to go out to the Lake Mývatn area. Take 3, day 10. Last night we found our camping spot in the middle of the night at midnight in the dark, and it rained all night. And now here we are in these mountains. We're somewhere in the northwest, west of Akurai. Yesterday we spent the day in Lake Mývatn, or Mývatn. We checked out the crater at Dimmuborgir. Today we are not sure exactly where we're going, but we're just driving southwest towards Reykjavik to find some hiking. We're out here on the frontier.
Day 10 on the grid.
Off the grid. Mara's holding up our tarp to make some delicious
pizza
sandwiches. They're going to be open face, but right now we're heating them.
Hello.
We are driving along the very gravelly, bumpy dirt road.
We've been driving for 5.5 hours.
We've been driving along the Snaffle Sneeze,
peninsula to get out to Stikishmoler, the small town of 1,100 people.
This way, right?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Mara Ludmer.
Folks, this is a big maneuver. Big audience.
They have these in most playgrounds in Iceland.
3, 2, 1, swing!
Softly now in the evening dusk, a woman is singing to me and she takes me back down the vista of my years until I see a boy, a child. Underneath the piano and the boom of the tingling strings, pressing the poised feet of his mother, who smiles at him as she sings. Yearning to belong, yearning to belong. My heart beats with the ceaseless longing, yearning to belong. In spite of myself and all of these nursery songs, my heart beats with the ceaseless longing, lover, yearning to belong.
I'm stuck.
It's day 11, our last day on the frontier. Tomorrow we gotta return to the van. We're on the Snæfellsnes Peninsula outside Stikishmoler. It's been pouring rain. Dumping buckets all night. It's been crazy windy. We were a little worried that we were gonna get flooded or something like that, but I think it sounded worse than it was. That's life in the Outback, you know. We're gonna go hike. We're gonna hike that mountain.
Day 12, last day with Harry. Mara.
Miss you, Harry. Miss the guy behind the camera. Okay, let me talk. All right, we're going to Blue Lagoon.
Softly now in the evening dusk, a woman is singing to me and she takes me back down the vista of my years until I see a boy, a child. Underneath the piano and the boom of the tingling strings, pressing the poised feet of his mother, who smiles at him as she sings. Yearning to belong, yearning to belong. My heart beats with the ceaseless longing, lover, yearning to belong. In spite of myself and all of these nursery songs, my heart beats with the ceaseless longing, lover, yearning to belong.